To the esteemed attendees, organizers, and facilitator of this colloquium, Head of UPCNAG, Dr. Jerk Principe, and to the distinguished speakers for this morning, good morning. It's an honor for the Department of Energy to be part of this Project CNAG. And harnessing the energy from the sun to contribute more power to the country through solar PV technology is not new already in the Philippines. Since the effectivity of the Republic Act 9513 or the RE Act, an act promoting the development, utilization, and commercialization of renewable energy resources and for other purposes, which was established on December 18, 2008. And the main objective is to accelerate the development of the country's renewable energy resources, such as biomass, solar, wind, hydro, geothermal, and ocean energy resources. Today, we have already accumulated a total of 1,247.6 megawatt or 1,310.690 megawatt peak of the solar installed capacity for the commercial business. And we also have a total of 6,640 megawatt for the on-use or self-generating solar plant. Currently, the potential capacity for commercial operations is about 19,991 plus megawatt peak, while 9.99 for megawatt peak for own use. The DOE is still receiving a numerous intents to develop solar panels or solar plants through solar energy operating contracts with the DOE. And in 2021, as you are aware, we have the RE comprised of 29% of the installed capacity and 22% of the gross power generation of the country. The solar share for that capacity is 4.9%. With the Renewable Energy G Act in 2008, the Republic Act intend to, as I said, accelerate the development of the country's renewable energy resources, including solar PV technology. And through this, the DOE has established various policies to improve or to develop this technology like solar, which include fiscal and non-fiscal incentives to encourage private sector engagement and investments in renewable energy projects. To name a few of DOE's policy mechanism, these are renewable portfolios standards for on-grid and off-grid. We have feed-in tariff, the Green Energy Option Program, and we have also the net metering, and the recent one is the Green Energy Option Program. The renewable portfolio standards means mandates load serving entities to source a minimum percentage of renewable energy in their respective supply portfolios. It increases the minimum annual RE percentage increase from the objective from 1.5% to 2.5% to be started in 2023. And the objective is to support the aspirational target of 35% RE share or renewable energy share in the power by 2030 and 50% of RE share by 2040. Another one is the feed-in tariff system policy. This was designed to provide a guaranteed fixed price to RE investors for a period of 20 years. To promote and develop the renewable energy technology. And another one is the Green Energy Program. This is a voluntary policy mechanism that allows end users with 100 kilowatt and above demand to source their electricity supply from renewable energy resources. And this is an unregulated already through contracts with the RE supplier. And currently, we have already 18 renewable energy suppliers for the Green Energy Option Program. Next, we have also the net metering. This will allow end user to install up to 100 kilowatt renewable energy system to reduce electricity bills and sales surplus of these solar PV to the grid transforming consumers. And the DOE, to support this net metering program, the DOE issued a department circular DC 2020-10-0020 prescribing the policies to enhance the net metering program. And also currently last April 2022, the DOE issued a net metering guidebook, which was already published in the DOE website for reference of the stakeholders. Another one, we have also the Green Energy Auction Program, which intends to support and facilitate the immediate and timely investments in new additional RE capacities. This is the auction, like the feed-in tariff. We have an auction for the renewable energy. The first auction was completed last June 24, 2002 with a target capacity of 2,000 megawatt. And through these policy mechanisms, the DOE have been innovating its policies and strategies for its continuously developing RE through mandatory and voluntary programs and collaborate with the stakeholders and development partners. So the DOE also provides, as shown, the fiscal incentives that can be availed by the RE developers, manufacturers, and fabricators registered at the DOE. Incentives, amongst other, includes endorsement like duty-free importation for RE components, parts, and materials. We have also VAT exemptions to all manufacturers, fabricators, and suppliers of locally produced RE equipment, income tax holiday, and tax credit on domestic capital equipment and services. Other incentives that can be availed are the tax rebate for purchase of RE components and financial assistance program from government financial institutions. Also, with the increase of utilization of solar PV technology, the DOE has coordinated with the Bureau of Philippine Standards for the establishment of the Philippine National Standards for Solar PV Equipment and Installations, which include on-grid and off-grid hybrid systems. Now, with the implementation of these policy mechanisms, fiscal and non-fiscal incentives, as well as the research of the Project CNAG, the DOE looks forward to more solar PV projects in our country. The DOE will continue to work hard to formulate and implement policy plans and programs, as well as collaborate with other government agencies, to our stakeholders and private sectors to accelerate the development, transformation, utilization, and commercialization of solar PV projects. Further, the DOE supports this Project CNAG in achieving its expected outputs, such as solar PV resource potential maps, solar PV power output forecasting model, wherein it will be beneficial to the solar energy development in the country and also to our renewable energy developers. Now again, on behalf of Director Mylene Gambongkol and from the DOE, thank you very much for having us in this esteemed colloquium. Thank you.